when I was washing cars.
Okay.
For $30 a day.
Wow.
8 a.m. to 8 p.m.
That's real. It's Kiss Hip Hop with your boy DJ MK. I'm joined by the legend, the boss of all bosses. He's back in the UK. My man, Rick Ross. What's good, baby?
Much love, big homie. Good to see you again.
Good to see you too, man.
Better believe it. Feel good to be seen.
Yeah. So, back in the UK. You're no stranger to the UK, man. You've been coming here for what, the last 12 years?
Oh, man. My first time coming to the UK was on a Jay-Z World Tour. Wow. He brought me out that summer. I want to say it was 06.
06, yeah. That's what I'm thinking too.
06, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
The UK's always had mad love for you.
Always.
Since the beginning, I can definitely say
every,
that, man.
You know, every time I ever came out here, you know what I'm saying? Mm. The experience was always, whenever I boarded that flight back home, I was like, I can't wait to come back.
Mm. Mm.
You know what I mean? It's a lot of spots that I just skipped over or, you know, that flight too long, but I ain't missing no UK trip.
Yeah, that's what we like.
Anytime it's on the itinerary, baby, I'm going to make
you
it.
Know that. You
believe
know
that.
So listen, man, album number 10. Port of Miami 2. I was saying to you off air, like, most people don't reach album number 3. We're in the times of social media, you know, where people are hot for like 2 weeks, a month, maybe a year. So
that's if they're lucky.
That's if they're very lucky.
Yeah.
So how does it feel to be an artist and have 10 albums out, and not only just 10 albums, but 10 classic albums? You've never made a bad album. And like in hip hop, if you look back at the greats, like I was saying, like Gangsta, Tribe Called Quest, EPMD, De La Soul, they've all had albums where you can't say any of them are whack.
Right.
And you've done that. So how does that feel?
Man, it just, I think honestly, it's just a reflection of how serious, you know, me being a student of the game is. You know what I mean? I never took no success I ever had. I never took anything for granted. So anytime it was time for me to make an album, I always went at it like, yo, I gotta over-deliver. Always bring something to the table that nobody expected. Always say something that's like, yo, I can't believe Ross said that. You know what I mean? Mm. I always issue challenges or accepted challenges.
Right.
That's just me being a student of the game. Yeah. And I always made sure I balance my production.
Right.
Me being a student from the East Coast to the West Coast to that's most right. definitely coming from the South.
Yeah.
And I think that's what kind of, you know, helped spawn that longevity, yeah. that sound.
Yeah. Because I remember last time when you were up here a couple of years back, you know, you were talking about, again, the same thing, the student of the game. We're talking about, you know, Kool G Rap, dudes like that who inspired you, obviously, you know, rolling with EPMD. And I don't think people know really your history in this game. It's not like 2006,
no.
you just came out and you're a new rapper. You've put in mad work, more work than most people.
Yeah.
And the patience you've had.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? That's incredible, man.
And the patience came from me really loving hip hop, really right. loving the culture.
Yeah.
And you know, when I spoke about Kool G Rap, when I spoke about all the legends, the single I released, Green Gucci Suit, just the title alone, that was a reflection
of I was gonna say.
That era.
Yeah.
When I looked at, you know, when I saw, when I'm a youth, I'm a youngster, and I saw the Follow the Leader album cover, and it was
Aaron
B and Rakim looking over their shoulder.
Mean.
I seen that jacket, I'm like, yo.
Need that.
I go robbing just to get that damn jacket. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, yo. And it was like, only the legends, only the OGs, only certain people made it to that status. Mm. And that was the conversation me and Future had when we said Green Gucci Suit.
Mm.
You know, that was going back to Dapper Dan.
That's right.
Which, who made those jackets for Kool G Rap, for Eric B and Rakim.
Salt and Pepper.
For Salt and Pepper, the Fat Boys, LL, you know, Jay-Z. The list goes on. You know, I went and met with him earlier this year, and I went in Harlem.
Yeah.
And he gave me those stories of Alpo coming in there dropping 30 grand, like yo,
nothing.
Lace me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's the culture,
ain't no,
right?
I ain't asking you.
Yeah.
Yeah, and when you talk about the culture, I always felt the music and the fashion went hand in hand.
Of course.
Even if we don't say it enough, fashion is just as important in hip hop as the music.
Yeah, totally.
You know what I mean? Your style, your dress. It's a lot of people who I may not even be fans of they art, they music, but the style they bring, yo, it made me a fan. It convinced me. I listen, I get at another try. Even if it was something that I might have said, yo, that song was whack to me. But you know what? The fashion and the style homie got, I'm going to give him another opportunity and keep a clear mind. And the next time I hear something, that might be the one that reel me in as a fan. You know what I mean? So it all go hand in hand with the culture.
Mm. So when you met Dapper Dan, like, did that bring you back to being like a teenager, to being a kid?
Of course. That's all I asked him about. I only wanted to ask questions about...
Hear those stories, right?
Yeah, of course. And when he walked me through the trap, like, yo, just the underground spot where I was creating a lot of this. Mm. You know, I was doing a lot of things I wasn't supposed to do, but I had to bring it to life for the game. And I'm just like, I'm looking on the wall. And, you know, once I got to that classic Eric B. and Rakim photo, I just stopped instead. And he looked at me and was like, yo, I ain't even have to ask. He like, I'm going to send you an original photo of that.
Ooh.
So that's now in my estate.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
You know, straight from Dap. And I just went down the line of all the original classic photos I got in front of Salt and Pepper. And I was like, you know what? Before I even heard their music, when I saw this poster with them jackets they had on, I was like, I'm a fan. Not only because they cute, but they fly.
Yeah.
They dress like dope boys. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And you know, Dap brought that to life.
Yeah.
And once again, That's the fashion sense from the jewels to the gear you was wearing. All that played a major role in. And when, you know, I chose who was my favorite MCs, that's what I was basing it off.
Mm.
Your style, your vibe, you know what I mean? So when Follow the Leader came out, when Eric B. and Rakim dropped Paid in Full, and I saw those double ropes, I saw those Dapper Dan jackets, this my favorite MC right now. This him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And how Eric B. just ain't speaking in videos.
I used to love that.
That was just, he had rings on every finger, scratch, and if he do get a cameo, he wasn't smiling, he wasn't saying shit. I was like, yo, these legends, man.
I remember I got on Twitter about 9 years ago, and Eric B. followed me. And I was like, yo. That was like one of the best moments.
Now, when I met him, I was like, yo, I gave it up to him. You know what I'm saying? I mentioned certain things to him that I think really surprised him. We exchanged numbers and we kept in touch for a long time. And to me, that was the golden era of the game.
Yeah,
Eric B. and Rakim, that was the first hip-hop act to get a 7-figure record deal.
Yeah.
And that's why they titled the album Paid in Full. And I was like, it all makes sense on me.
Yeah. And it's good to see Dapper Dan getting his props now.
Almost definitely.
30 years later.
Yeah, most definitely. You know what I mean? It's like our coach always went against the grain and went against the world. But now it's too powerful to go against.
Mm.
Anything that's outside of hip hop, take my advice. Don't go against hip hop. Mm. Don't go against the streets.
Mm.
You're going to lose.
Mm.
You know what I mean? So just to see Gucci embrace the movement, it's love. It's win-wins for both sides.
Yeah. And it makes sense for them as well because they have to do that, man.
They wasn't eating with none of that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, when they could have been. Yeah.
Now they get it. You know what I mean? And now, you know, green Gucci suit out now and everybody, you know, with it. And we going to make a huge announcement next week that's going to be, you know, for everybody repping the record, repping, you know, Rosé. And we going to give them an opportunity to meet with Dapper Dan and get them a Gucci suit made.
Wow.
You heard it here first.
Support of Miami 2, it's going to be out real soon. Green Gucci suit jumping off in the clubs. Obviously, the video is out there doing its thing. What can you tell us about the new album?
Well, you know, like I say, I never took any of my projects for granted. And I felt like me making it the album number 10, I felt like I came full circle. And it feels like I'm right back at the beginning.
Okay.
Where once again, being how competitive the new era, the new age, I gotta show the game what the boss mean to it.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I think that type of challenge that push and shove feel is what keeps, you know, pushing this shit forward.
Mm.
And that's what it's about. And on album number 10, me being here on the 10th one, that's what I'm doing. It's like it's my first to me all over again. That's right. Why it's part of Miami too, right. All over again.
Right. But that's what I think keeps you winning.
I believe so too.
You know?
I believe so too. I believe it's real easy to get comfortable when you get in certain positions.
Mm.
You know? But my love for this is too deep. It run too deep. And like you say, I was a decade in before I ever got an opportunity, before I ever got on.
Yeah.
You know, when I collaborated with Kanye and I spoke about having sessions with Yeezy before his jaw wired. Mm. You know what I mean? You know, I don't even want to say how much he may have been selling beats for at the time when we was in the studio, but it was one of those type of sessions when we met.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Mm. It was, you know, I'm in the studio in the B room with an artist. I don't even want to say who I was writing raps for. You know what I'm saying? Because it ain't nothing to get no props from. You know what I'm saying? And he was in another room. And it's like when we finally got a break and we probably was digging out the same McDonald's bag, busting down fish fillets or something. Sure, you never know. Sure. And it was just, yo, let me hear some of that and I'm going to play you some of mine and damn, let's stay in touch. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's what that was years before we both got on.
That's crazy. So with this album, is it the same process of putting it together as all of the other albums? Are you in one spot? Are you going to studios, or you're traveling?
Yeah.
How are we doing this?
I'm moving around. Mm. I'm moving around from Cali, Miami, New York.
Mm.
You know what I mean? And I'm still moving as a youth. You know what I mean?
Mm.
Because everything not gonna come to you.
Mm. True.
When you establish yourself, that's when you do get a lot of producers, and you know you in Miami and I could kick it with Pharrell. I could go see Timberland and all that. And that's cool. I love the legends. But like I say, I feel like I'm back at album number one. So
hungry.
You could be working at Publix, bagging up groceries. And if you making beats, I don't care.
Mm.
If you got that heat, I'm with that.
Mm.
And so it's a lot of times I had to go certain places and sit down with certain people just to get catch that vibe.
Mm. I mean, your ears are incredible because, like, the beats you pick are just crazy. And not only do they bang, not only do they work, but they suit you perfectly. Like, how do you do that, man? Like, keep that consistency. Come on, man. That's incredible.
Like I say, I think that just come from me really, really loving it. You know, when I was young, when we was young, I was the only one that'll go and buy a cassette or buy a vinyl,
okay.
Play the vinyl, and turn it over to the back first.
Read those credits, read everything.
I want to read the address, where the record label, where it was manufactured.
Right.
The smallest print is always what I wanted to see the most of.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And that's just how deep my love for it went. And so when it came to producers and production, you know, I still hit Q-Tip for beats, still to this day.
That.
You know what I'm saying? So I still go through certain eras of production and sounds all the way up to 2018.
Mm.
But I'm going to start back and reach out to the OGs from the 80s.
Okay.
You know, Superfly was just releasing a collaboration, you know, and, you know, Pete Rock, and, you know, I still want to collaborate with these guys, legends.
I was going to say, like, what legends do you still want to, like, collaborate with? You said Pete Rock, obviously.
Yeah. And, you know, I always keep my door open to that sound. It's just, it's a certain vibe that I just look for.
Mm.
It's just, and I wanted to feel that balance. So if you're from the East Coast, and you know I'm from Miami, you know I'm from the South, you know I'm going to have those heavyweight records.
Mm.
I got a record called Big Fish. You know, that's a nickname that, you know, me and Meek got. I call him Lil Fish, he called me Big Fish. That's something that we used to joke about.
Right.
We'll be in the club in VIP, and we might see a chick coming through. Oh, yeah, she looking at you, Lil Fish. You know what I'm saying? or he'll be like, yeah, she want the big fish. You know what I'm saying? And so that was the first time me even breaking down where we get our nicknames from and what they really represent. But that was just something that we did. You know what I mean? And it was just a little fun thing we did in the club. And when you hear the production, that take you to that every day I'm hustling BMF where it just tilt the whole room and it's so heavy. As well as, you know, when we spoke, like we was just speaking off camera and we brought up Santorini, Greece off my last album where it's a real kind of, you know, when I listened to Eric B. and Rakim as a youngster and I heard Mahogany and I just said, man, you know what I'm saying? Or I was listening to Tribe Called Quest, Check the Rhyme, or, you know, it's just, I want to be able to, I think that's what always made my production sound just a little different, is me being able to balance all that into one album and make it meet somewhere in the medium, and it felt natural.
Yeah, because with every album you've dropped, not only is it dope music, but it takes you somewhere. And you feel like you're a billionaire. Like
right.
feel like, you know what I mean, the palm trees are there, and you know what I mean?
That's what I wanted.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because When I my first three or four bars in every rap, I usually take myself back to that mind frame of when I was washing cars.
Okay.
For $30 a day.
Wow.
8 a.m. to 8 p.m.
That's real.
You know what I'm saying? And I remember, you know, all the hustlers pulling up. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to wash your car. I'm going to vacuum it. Not only that, I'm going to degrease your seats for you. And if you stay gone long enough, I'm going to go back to your car when I'm free, cut it on, and listen through your music CD, booklet, or your cassettes. I'm going to put them in alphabetical order for you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right, so whenever the hustlers pulled up, they like, I want the little dirty fat kid over there to wash mine. You know what I mean? Because that $30 a day plus tips, you need them tips. So
exactly.
If I knew you was a hustler, I was going to go all the way out for you. And that's usually my mind state I put myself in. Mm. So regardless of where you at in life, or, you know, whatever position you in, you're going to understand something in this verse. Mm.
Mm.
You know what I mean? And that's where my me wanting more come from.
Because
I was right across the street from self-made millionaires and, you know, you eating those Vienna sausages, but it's so close, but it's so far. So we got to just bring that together, and that's what I always wanted to do with my lyrics.
I was just thinking, even just from this conversation now, I'd love to see a Rick Ross film.
You know what? And, you know, I feel like it's inevitable. But it's not nothing that I ever wanted to rush.
Yeah.
Because I wouldn't want, that couldn't fail. Sure. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I feel like, I'm being around certain things in the film, you know what I mean? In the film industry now, shout out to Joel Silver, shout out to the director, Lil X, my little cameo I got in Superfly, the little cameo in Uncle Drew, and the little things I got coming up.
Mm.
It's like I'm easing into it.
Okay.
But I feel like, you know, the time gonna be right and everything gonna come together. And I feel it's gonna happen because it's so many people with so much in common.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I can't even front. It's a hell of a story.
Yeah. And how do you feel like when you're in front of the camera? Is that a relaxed situation?
Yeah, I'd be cool. Chilling.
Yeah.
Because, you know, it could go either way with me. You know what I mean?
Mm.
I could be a very obnoxious motherfucker. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I'm one of them dudes that whatever the vibe is whatever. You know what I mean?
Sure,
I could be real chill, laid back, just enjoy the smoke, just sipping on some Luke Belair. Or it could be some, yo, we got to make sure they understand what this is. You know what I'm saying? And don't take that cool side for granted. So,
exactly.
You know, and, you know, me being a student, I always got along with DJs. And, you know, always, anytime I was behind the camera, it was always cool.
Mm. So Port of Miami 2, out real soon. I heard there's a track with Cardi B.
Yeah, shout out to Cardi.
Using the case?
Yeah.
Touch Me, Tease Me?
Yeah.
Whose idea was that?
That was actually my idea.
Okay.
That was my idea. Shout out to Beat Billion. I was just sitting in there. I was like, yo, that beat was just so classic. That was one of those beats that, damn.
The drums in that as well.
If I could have, you know, any beats, that was one of them. That'll walk, once again, that balanced line for dudes, hustlers, and females. That was one of my favorite beats of all time. And I was like, yo, I want to get Cardi on this, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I reached out to her, and boy, did she deliver.
She
went above and beyond for Rosé, so I got to salute her and congratulate her.
Yeah, she's killing
on
it.
Her, you know, what she doing, her success.
Yeah, it's incredible. So, I mean, there's so many new artists coming out, and like you said, you're a student of the game, you're always paying attention. Do you try and check out as many new artists as possible, or when you're recording, do you just go, I ain't going to pay attention to that, I'm just going to do me? How does it work?
It's like you got to catch my eye. As an artist, it's your job to catch my eye. You can't just DM me and send me a link. Yo, Rosé, check it out. Hell nah, I ain't checking that out. What you going to say first? What you going to do first? That's going to demand my attention. And when you do, it's a little young dude out of Miami. It's Cash. I just actually followed him on IG maybe 2 or 3 days ago.
Okay.
And, you know, it was just what he was saying. Then he'll send a link 2 or 3 days later. And I finally clicked one. Let me listen to another one. Let me go to his YouTube page. And that's what it is. I get a thousand links in every day. You know what I mean?
I bet.
What you gonna do that's different? And that's what being recognized as an artist is all about. Most definitely, your success is gonna be based on your talent. But what are you going to do that's unique as an artist to separate yourself from all the lames? Everybody who tell you the same thing, yo. Nah, you got to do something that's special, homie.
So what advice would you give to like a 16-year-old MC trying to get into the game now, which in some ways it's easier than ever because, you know, with social media, stuff that we didn't have back in the day.
Right.
But the flip side of that is, you know, attention spans are going down for 5 seconds, and everyone wants to get in the game. So what advice would you give?
Would be most definitely put as much time as you do into your making your music, creating your music, and perfecting your craft into the way you present yourself. It's a lot of kids that may go in the studio and put 40 hours a week in the studio and only spend 15 minutes on the way they're going to approach you.
Right.
And it don't work that way. Because the way you approach somebody is just as important as the music you playing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And with me, where I am as far as being an executive, your character means maybe even more to me than your level of skill.
Right.
You see, I done sat in the studio with years and develop artists and help artists and, you know, so it's a certain type of artist I want to work with, not just if you hot.
Yeah. Or if you,
because it's a lot of artists that's got a buzz who I could take a bag to. Yo, come to MMG, but that ain't what I want right now.
Right.
You know what I mean?
So let's just get it straight. What is the lineup now of MMG?
Most definitely Meek Mill. Shout out to Meek Mill. Meek Mill home.
That's a good look, man.
Yeah.
So cut you short. So how was that whole situation, man? Because that was terrible with him.
Oh, most definitely. It was a disgusting and unfortunate situation little bro was in, but I'm so proud of him. Because a lot of times we all go through, you know, certain things to understand our true purpose, find our true identity. And I feel like I'm proud to see him come home and accept his role is being a bigger voice for a lot of young brothers that's still in that same predicament who don't have that platform, who don't have those finances, those attorneys, those supporters, who don't have Rosé, Jay-Z, and countless others who really stepped out there screaming Free Meek Mill for that whole time.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And he shed light on what I like to call some straight fuck shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it got to be changes made.
Yeah.
And like I just said about hip-hop, don't go against the streets, you know what I mean? Because we only going to unite when it's right. That's the beautiful thing about the game. Everybody only going to come together when it's something that's right. You know what I mean? You can have your own agenda, your own whatever it is, but when it's right, everybody going to hold you down. And that's what Meek's situation was. And hopefully, the way he came home and hopefully get that behind him, it's thousands and thousands of others that deserve that same opportunity. Mm. And that's who he's speaking on behalf of now. So shout out to Meek Mill. Mm.
So who else have we got in the lineup of MMG right now?
Of course, you know, Young Wale, Ralph Lauren. Yeah. MMG, you know, yeah. Just got him a new situation over at Warner. Shout out to Warner Brothers over there. The whole team, and you know,
he's a hard working dude, man. Wale.
Wale is most definitely a unique artist, and you know, I love his, you know, just his mindset. Mm. You know what I mean? He's an extremely passionate person. You know what I mean? Wale will call you 3 a.m, yo, and you like, yo. You know what I mean? Yeah, and but his music and his wordplay reflects that, so it's all worth it. Mm, mm. You know, everybody ain't worth those Wale calls you get. Yeah, you know what I mean?
But you know, if you pick it up, it's going to be worthwhile conversation.
It's most definitely he finna use some big words and, and say some, you know, ain't no telling how the conversation going to go, but that's what you love him for. Mm. And when you genuinely got love for him, and I do, you know what I mean, because it's like we all came from the first floor together. I had just got my label deal over at Warner, and you know, I signed Meek, I signed Wale, of course, Gunplay on the team, and then I got Yada out of Vegas, and you know, it's a few youngsters that's on the team that I just, you know, feel need a little more time doing what they doing before we put them on that big platform, because I still believe in true artist development and really just perfecting your craft. But you know, that's the lineup.
Yeah. So let's also just touch on for a second, like your different business ventures outside of hip hop that people might not even know about, like you know, the Wingstop and stuff.
Yeah. Most definitely. Shout out to Wingstop. Wingstop coming over to the UK.
I was gonna say we need that here, man.
Yeah. Most definitely. It's on the way.
Okay.
It's on the way. It's cracking.
How many branches have you got now?
I don't even know, honestly.
Yeah, it's a lot though.
Hey, we doing our thing. Shout out to Wingstop. They supporting our team. They support my family. And you know, the team I got, you know, we steady making progress.
Yeah.
And I let them know, as we continue to grow, let's continue to spread our wings.
Yeah.
You know, and so we just keep going. Yeah. And Wingstop winning in a major way. Shout out to all the lemon pepper lovers out there. You dig? Shout out to Checkers and Rallies. You know, we got into the burger business as well. I went back and bought the same spot that when I was working at the car wash, we used to, because at that same intersection behind the gas station, we washed cars. It was a McDonald's, a Burger King, a Wendy's, and across the street was Checkers. And if you went over to Checkers and spent $5, the bag would be way heavier when you came back. So that's where we went. And that's where, you know, our love was. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Of course, I entertained all the other spots as I got older, but I was like, you know, and that's how I keep it.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
And it's a family thing as well, right?
Yeah, most definitely. Mm-hmm. And that's something that I preach. I believe in, you know, you got to empower and start with your family, your team.
Yeah.
You got to start with your team. If you want to stay rich forever, you got to empower everybody around you, or you'll just be taking care of everybody around you.
Yeah.
And I got all bosses around me. I don't even get calls for, yo, I need to borrow. Why? Nah. We got to all go get it now. Mm. I go too hard out here. We got all, and you know, my whole team understand and respect that, and everybody get that opportunity to come sit at the table. Whether it's a franchise, whether it's anything else, we all got to hustle hard. Mm, mm,
mm. When can fans expect Rick Ross back in the UK, maybe on a little tour or something like that?
Is that
going to be on the cards this year?
You know, we just making this quick run through just to let everybody over in UK know that Port of Miami 2 is most definitely dropping real soon. Mm-hmm. You know, represent for the single green Gucci suit, and once we drop the album, really over the next, possibly as early as the next week or so, we could be announcing the release date. Wow. And when I tell you it's coming real soon. And hopefully soon as we drop the album, within the next 60 to 90 days, which is 2 or 3 months, I need to be back over here.
Yeah.
Just making sure, you know, we come back, touch you guys, you know what I mean? And then, you know, just touch the city.
Yeah. I mean, that's one of the great things now about technology and the game. That you literally can go, right, it's going to be on Spotify tomorrow. Album's going to be out tomorrow.
Right.
Is that something you love?
I most definitely embrace the change.
Yeah, you have to.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Even though, you know, us OGs, we move slower when it comes to it, you know, because we, you know, we so stuck in our ways. You know, we so used to seeing certain things happen. But times change. Mm-hmm. And now it's all about streaming. And, you know, we was only focused on pure sales streams. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, but most definitely, that's a part of the game now. And I embrace it. And we most definitely need it.
Mm-hmm. Well, listen, brother, it's been a pleasure talking to you. Port of Miami 2, out real soon, so pay attention.
Very soon,
and we want to see you back here this year.
Oh, I most definitely will be back this year. That's without a doubt. The boss, I'm going to be here.
That's right. Much love, brother.
Much love.
Peace.